So very good morning everyone. Myself Amit Kasbe, editor Aster Edit Pune, welcome all the participants and viewers who are attending this online free webinar and training session at our YouTube channel organized by Aster Edit Pune on the topic Plagiarism, Don't Get Trapped Yourself and Academic Writing. The first topic is going to be conducted by me, and another topic titled Academic Writing is going to be taken by Mr. Vivek Engle, Assistant Professor, Yeshu College of Pharmaceutical Sciences and Research Center, Kharadi, Pune, tomorrow at 11 a.m. onwards. In the topic Plagiarism, Don't Get Trapped Yourself, I am going to take two module sessions. In module 1, we are going in detail regarding introduction to plagiarism, types of plagiarism, and what it will cost if you do so. And after this session at 1 p.m., we will be dealing with module 2, and it includes interesting part. It includes how to avoid plagiarism, plagiarism detecting softwares, and similarity index. And after the end of this session, the participant need to answer the quiz, which will open at 4 p.m. today and will remain active to solve the questionnaire up to 5 p.m. tomorrow. So solve this quiz successfully to get the training completion certificate. Don't worry, if you are not able to solve the quiz, each registered participant will get the participation certificate. So with this information regarding our webinar and training session, we will move towards the module 1. Okay, so in module 1, we are going to see three important points: introduction to plagiarism, types of plagiarism, and what it will cost if you do so. So first point, that is introduction to plagiarism. So plagiarism is an unethical practice of using or copying word-to-word text from previously published research or review article or thesis or ideas of another author or researcher. If you copied anything without proper acknowledgement, it is considered as a plagiarism. So even if you copied some text from your previously published data and used without proper acknowledgement of all other authors, then also it falls under plagiarism, and the type is called as a self-plagiarism. So considering a serious academic and intellectual offense, plagiarism can result in highly negative consequences, such as it may lead to paper retraction, and it may lead to loss of author credibility, and also loss your reputation. So it is currently a grave problem in academic publishing and a major reason for retraction of research paper. Generally, plagiarism, it is categorized into two types, that is, it may be planned or it may be accidental. The planned plagiarism, it also called as a intentional, or it is also termed as a cheating. So planned, it is a intentional cheating. It is defined as obtaining or attempting to obtain credit for work by any dishonest or deceptive means. It may occur due to the submission of a work, either in a part or in a whole, which is completed by another author or researcher. Also, it may occur due to failure to give credit for ideas, your statement or facts, or even conclusion which rightfully belongs to another person. So this is planned plagiarism, how it occurs. And generally, accidental plagiarism occurs when a person neglect to cite their sources, or which may lead to misquoting their sources, or unintentionally paraphrases a source by using similar words, or it may be due to group of words, and or may be due to sentences structure without attribution. So this accidental plagiarism, it may lead due to failure to use quotation marks, or it may lead due to credit to the work. So before heading to the point, we'll see what can be plagiarized. On your screen, you are observing different things which can be plagiarized. Anything can be plagiarized, but with respect to article publication, it may be ideas, It may be concept, it may be hypothesis, it may be title, it may be text, it may be material and methods, or even result and discussion part, also entire clinical data set, or even we can copy discussion, charts, tables, images, figures, or even entire article can be plagiarized. So according to the severity of plagiarism, plagiarism can be categorized into following points. The first point is extent, originality, type of material, referencing, attribution, and intention. So these are the five different attributes considered by Committee on Publication Ethics while grading severity of plagiarism. The role of different committees against plagiarism and academic integrity we are going to see in next point. So with respect to extent of plagiarism, the possibilities that are varying amount of contents may be taken from the article which is being plagiarized from. So in worsening grade of severity, the amount may be a few words or a few sentences or whole paragraph or several paragraphs or even whole paper. So this is the extent of plagiarism. So for easy understanding, we have highlighted here the table with color coding. On your screen you are observing a table which is enlightened with the color, different colors. So the first one, that is a few words, it indicates very fair, which is denoted by the color blue one, and it is called as a similarity index, and it is considered as a minor type of plagiarism. So in similarity index we need to just revise the content, whereas if you copied whole paragraph or several paragraphs or even whole paper, it is not fair or even critical, or it may be very critical. And these all yellow color, orange color and red color, they indicate the pure plagiarism, and it is generally categorized into major plagiarism type, and this plagiarism, it should be totally banned. So plagiarism and similarity index, these are the different terms. So about it different, we are going to see in our next module 2 session. So severity level also grouped into major and minor plagiarism under the following circumstances. So what is mean by minor plagiarism and what is mean by major plagiarism? Minor plagiarism is occur if verbatim copy of less than 100 words without quotation from an original work, unless the text is universally accepted or has been standardized or standard technique. Verbatim simply means a similar words, or even it may due to close copying of significant section which may be greater than 100 words from another work, whether or not that work is cited. So this is the case in which minor plagiarism occurs. And what is meant by major plagiarism and how it occurs? When any case which involves the unattributed copying of another person or its data or its findings or result and discussion or resubmission of an entire publication under another author's name, either in the original language or in maybe in translation language, it leads to major plagiarism. Also, verbatim copying of more than 100 words of the original material without any citation to the source material. And it may be due to unattributed use of original published work of another group of author, or it may be of researcher. So this is all about what is meant by minor and major plagiarism. So we'll move towards our next point, that is copy paste is your enemy. So don't try to copy paste, but what should we do to collect the data from article and thesis? So you can take it from by taking note taking or pre-writing, or you can write and cite. In note taking, cite sources, and use quote marks in your notes. Record page number for printed work or also for URLs for website. In pre-writing, after reading, highlighting and reflecting, make short summaries of the relevant sources. Organize these notes, plan your piece and make an outline. Whereas in write and cite, use your pre-writing material. While composing your draft, add citation as you go, consult original sources for details or clarification only. So in this case, you can copy paste the data. So the next question will come to your mind, can I copy text from Wikipedia? The answer will be no. Why? Although Wikipedia content is given away for free, it may be given away for free copying exactly from Wikipedia, it's still considered a plagiarism. If you are using it as a source, make it clear that you are quoting Wikipedia. In spite of the fact that Wikipedia's licensee allows you to reproduce the information without citing it. Even if you are a teacher, spot plagiarism, you won't get a good grade. So, Wikipedia content is created by other users just like you and us. Some of the professionals are and some are amateur. So you never can tell just who gathered the material for the Wikipedia article and who edited them. So ultimately, we need to check this fact. So Wikipedia is probably okay for a middle school essay, but do not use for thesis or article. Rather use academic databases. So with this, we will move to our next point, that is different types of plagiarism. Generally, plagiarism is classified into three important types: self-plagiarism, mosaic plagiarism, and direct plagiarism. So what is meant by self-plagiarism? Self-plagiarism occurs when someone uses his or her own previous published work or mixes parts of previous work without permission from all the authors who are involved in writing of article while authoring a new work, and maybe because of improper acknowledgement. This self-plagiarism, it is also called as a duplication or duplicate plagiarism. And generally, this self-plagiarism, it includes duplication, augmentation and text recycling. So we are going to see these terms one by one, what is meant by duplication, augmentation and text recycling. We'll see first one, that is what is meant by duplication. It means the use of same content with different titles in different journal. It is sometimes referred to as a misconduct. So duplicate publication can also refer to the practice of publishing the same information as a second time without acknowledging the first publication. So just listen carefully. Practice of publishing the same information as a second time without acknowledging the first publication, it is also duplication. So we should follow one study, one article, and not one study, multiple articles. Most of the authors nowadays, they following this habit, that is one study, multiple articles. But we recommend don't follow one study, multiple articles, but you should follow one study, one article to avoid the self-plagiarism. And what is meant by augmentation? When author's own study material, which is previously published, is expanded with more data and published second time, it is called as a simply augmentation. So it is to be noted that data once published should not be republished. It may merely be reference. You can reference it, but don't use the data for republishing. And so what is meant by text recycling? So repeating whole or a part of the article published again without following ethical procedure. So these are the three types which may lead to self-plagiarism. So generally, the authors, what they believe, they believe that they are the authors, they can use their work again as they wish. but they can't really plagiarize themselves because they are not taking any words or ideas from someone else. And also, in self-plagiarism, it may involve publisher, copyright, also and maybe authors unaware of the ethics and laws involved in the reusing the text. So how it leads to plagiarism? So generally, republishing of the same published paper that is published elsewhere without notifying the reader nor publisher of the journal. So it leads to the self-plagiarism. Also, publishing a significant study of smaller studies to increase the number of publication rather than publishing one large study. So this is the common way of self-plagiarism most of the author follows. That is, one study, multiple article to increase their CV. So also it leads to plagiarism due to reusing portion of a previously written, published or unpublished text. So with this, we'll complete what is meant by self-plagiarism, and we will move towards the next type of plagiarism, that is mosaic plagiarism. The mosaic plagiarism, it is also called as a patch writing. It is a simply habit of control C and control V. It is when a text is copied from a source without using quotation marks or replacing synonyms for the author language while keeping to the same general structure and meaning of the original. It is also called as a simply patch writing. It also occurs even if footnote your sources. So we have given here some examples of mosaic plagiarism. The first one, that is a patch writing. In this example, framing of a sentence without using quotation marks along with substitution of a synonyms or even omission of a occasional words or phrases and often retention of the same sentence structure as the original source. So this is the example of the mosaic plagiarism. Just simply here, just see on your screen, the source is mentioned. Also, patch writing plagiarism is mentioned. Only in patch writing, the synonyms are replaced. So the next type is direct plagiarism. So direct plagiarism is the word for word transcription of a section of a someone else's work without attribution and without quotation marks. So the deliberate plagiarism of someone else's work is unethical, or it may be academically dishonest and ground for a disciplinary action. So you can avoid direct plagiarism by using a different quotation marks. The quotation marks are your friend. So what is meant by direct quotation and what is meant by indirect quotation? So direct quotation means, to avoid plagiarism, you should always use quotation marks. When you are quoting the author verbatim, also you should use words or phrases such as stated or mentioned or mention that or in the words of, etc. So which indicate that you are using the author's exact words. Additionally, you should cite the source to avoid the direct plagiarism. So in case of indirect quotation, it is when you use the text with minor grammatical changes. In such a cases, you need to use quotation marks and cite the sources. So to generally just try to give the quotation marks to avoid the plagiarism. So here we are giving some guidelines to use the quotation marks. You can use the double quotation mark for a short quotation. Remember to use double quotation mark for short quotation, the first one. The second, include the author name before and after a quotation. Also, you need to acknowledge original sources and include them in reference list. Don't forget. Also, for long quotation, but up to 40 words, should be put in a block form without quotation marks. Just listen carefully. For a long quotation up to 40 words, it should be kept in a block form without quotation marks. But for a long quotation more than 40 words, you should put it in black with indent. Okay, so as per guidelines of American Psychological Association, we simply called it as a APA citation style, we should use indented 0.5 inches from the margin, double space without quotation mark. Essentially, a block quote, and here we have given the example how we need to indent if you copied more than a 40 words. So now we are going to see the demo on how to use the indent in paragraph. So this is the demo how we can use the indent. So next point that we are going to see, that is different examples which include direct plagiarism. On your screen you can observe here we have given one example of direct plagiarism. The green one, it is the original source, whereas the red highlighted area, it is a direct quotation. Okay. If you observe the these two brackets, you will come to know they have used the same wording in direct plagiarism. So this is the example of direct plagiarism. Also, this is the second example of direct plagiarism. It is a verbatim. Verbatim means from original sources in copied text. Only synonyms are replaced. So this is the verbatim type of plagiarism, which categorized under the direct plagiarism. So apart from previously listed different types of plagiarism, there are most common types of plagiarism, and which are ranks them according to the severity by different top plagiarism softwares. Here the list of most common types of plagiarism: clone, control C, find replace, remix, recycle, hybrid, mashup sources, 404 error, and aggregator. So these are the most common types of plagiarism. We are going to see one by one. So what is mean by clone? If you submit someone else's work word for a word as your own, this is called as a clone plagiarism. Control C, just copy paste. It is a cut paste culture from a single source without alteration. That is called as a control C. Find or replace. Keywords and phrases which are changed to distinguish the use of someone else's material, but the essential content of the source material is retained. So this is the find replace plagiarism. In remix, different paraphrases from multiple sources are made to fit together. Just remix the contents. Recycle means borrowing up generously from the writer's own previous work without citation. So this type is also called as a self-plagiarism. Recycle. Hybrid. It is a combination of cited sources with copied passage without citation. So this is called as a hybrid. And mashup means mixing or copying material from a multiple sources. And 404 error, it includes citation to non-existence or inaccurate information about sources. So this point is called as a fake referencing. In our next point, we are going to see what is meant by fake referencing. And the last type is aggregator. It includes proper citation to sources, but paper contains often no original work. So these are the most commonest type, which are categorized by different plagiarism softwares. So this is all about the introductory part of plagiarism and its types. And then we will move to the next point, that is what it will cost if you copy the or if you do the plagiarism. So academic integrity and plagiarism are concerns of the utmost importance to faculty and academicians. Academic integrity or academic honesty is the foundation for academic life. So it is the manner in which you behave in an academic environment when you do the research or even write a paper or if you are working on your project. So we should keep our integrity by maintaining honesty, trust, respect and responsibility. So academic integrity is the commitment to live by these values. Plagiarism is an aspect of academic integrity, in that using another ideas, word or even theories, illustrations or graphics, opinions or facts without giving credit is a dishonest. So it is a plagiarism. So if you do plagiarism, then it may lead to different types of consequences. So in next point, we are going to see different consequences of plagiarism. The person or plagiarist, it may be student, it may be researcher, faculty or any other who involved in plagiarism or may face serious consequences. So the first consequence is it affects the author. So after getting caught from the plagiarism of the author, the feeling of having been symbolically eliminated can be devastating. And even if nobody disputes that an individual has created the work in question, so it is a natural for the plagiarized to feel violated. So it also affects the reader community. Plagiarized publisher source may get threatened. Also, plagiarism, it destroys the link to the past knowledge by refusing readers to access the sources. Also, it may lead to infringement of a author. So publication of a copied or stolen or plagiarism of text may lead to infringement of a author future rights. Also, the plagiarism, it leads to the pointless research. Only rarely plagiarism, a copy paste of an entire work. Most plagiarists borrows patchily from previous publication. Also, by doing plagiarism, you're fraud yourself. So it makes it easy to lengthen the list of publication on your resume or on your CV, and it increases chances of promotion or recruitment. So plagiarism thus result in favoring the cheat to the detriment of the honest author. Also, plagiarism obstruct the work of a scientific journal. It is a persistent myth is that scientific journal remains the guardians of academic knowledge. Also, they provide the diffusing knowledge, or also they achieving canons of knowledge. And they quality control of publication and attributing author's reputation and ranking. So these journals are essential to academia, whose social world classifies researcher into those who are suitable to be hired by an institution or research center. So plagiarism, it affects the whole profession. Plagiarism discredit the whole profession. So plagiarism scandals also affect those who are not guilty, encouraging rumors about their integrity. And also plagiarism harms educational institute reputation where the plagiarist works. Also it destroys professional reputation. Also it leads to destruction of the student reputation. The student can get expelled or maybe get suspended from the institution. Their academic record can reflect the ethics offense, possibly causing the student to be barred from the entering college. Also it may need to get stepped down from their present position. So it destroys the student reputation as well as it leads to destruction of the professional reputation. Also it destroys the academic reputation. The consequences of plagiarism have been widely reported in the world of academia. Once scarred with the plagiarism allegation, an academic career can be ruined. So publishing is an integral part of a prestigious academic career. Also in most of the serious cases, it may lead to legal allegations. Also it may lead to plagiarized research. So when plagiarism in article get exposed, the journal may decide to publish errata. Also they lead to publish the apology letter to a public notice of retraction of the published article. So apart from this, the journal may levy penalty on the authors based on the severity of the plagiarism. So also the author may get blacklisted by the journal or publisher. So in case while reviewing or before sending article to review, if plagiarism is found, then what will happen? So article can be simply get rejected by giving different reasons. Also the journal, they inform the original author and he may take necessary action. Also the journal may inform to ombudsman of a medical writing so that the wider variety of scientific professionals are aware about the details of author who is making such a submission. Also if it is serious, then occasionally even it may lead to criminal offense. So throughout the world there are three different committees who discuss different cases relating to publication issues and publishes their findings. On your screen we have listed three committees, that is Committee on Publication Ethics, COP, World Association of Medical Editors, WAME, and International Committee on Medical Journal Editors. So these are the three committees for working throughout the world to maintain the publication ethics and academic integrity. So ethical issues we must consider before going for plagiarism or before doing plagiarism. When an author publishes in a journal, the author often signs over right to the publisher. Thus, copyright infringement is possible if an author reuses portion of a previous published work. It is a case of self-plagiarism, and also it may protect by copyright law. In signing a contract with a publisher, an author guarantees that the work is original and that the author owns it. Also that no part of it has been previously published, and that no other agreement to publish or part of it is outstanding. So we need to consider this ethical issue while doing the plagiarism. And if any author, if still he do the plagiarism, then we should call it as a irresponsible author. So irresponsible authorship can be of various types. It may be ghost authorship, it may be guest authorship, or omitting authorship, or changing order of authorship which does not comply with prior mutual agreement between the author, also not giving due credit to the degree of contribution of author's amount to authorship plagiarism. So what if you found plagiarism to your own content or to your own published article? So there are several ways you can tackle with this to protest the plagiarism. In case of a published article, you can write it to the editor of the concerned journal where you have published your article. In case of thesis, it may be of PhD or maybe of PG, you can write it to the UGC InfliNet Ombudsman stating the issue clearly. Also, in case of PG thesis, you can write to concerned university ombudsman. Also, in most of the serious cases, you can contact to any one of the following committees, that is WAME, IC, MJE and COP, that is World Association of Medical Editors, International Committee of Medical Journal Editors and Committee on Publication Ethics. So here we are ending up with the UGC guidelines, which are given according to level of similarity index. These are provided in the year 2018 under the promotion of academic integrity and prevention of plagiarism in higher educational institutions. UGC categorize similarity index with these four levels: level 0, level 1, level 2 and level 3. If similarity is up to 10%, it is a level 0. If it is more than 10% but below 40%, it is a level 1. If it is in between 40% to 60%, it is a level 2. And if it is above 60%, then it is a level 3. So according to level of similarity, it is categorized by the UGC. And if plagiarism is found in thesis or article, then it may lead to different penalties which are defined by the UGC New Delhi. So in case of penalties in submission of thesis and dissertations, up to 10%, there is no penalty. Up to 40% or in between 10% to 40%, it may ask to resubmit the thesis within stipulated time. Or in case of level 2 similarity index, it may lead to debarred for 1 year. Or in case of level 3, it may lead to cancellation of the registration of PhD or PG. So this is the in case of penalties in submission of thesis and dissertation. But what in case of submission of an article up to 366.16. So we will take a break and we will meet at session 2 module 2 at 1 p.m. Don't miss it. The session is more interesting. Thank you.